Good evening, folks. It's Diamond with the Oppenheimer Ranch Project, bringing you a grand solar minimum update Sunday, July 15th, 10:16 p.m. Mountain Time, 2018. Here we are at Mount Agung. Another impressive eruption to about 17,000 feet into the atmosphere. Just happening hours ago. More uptick in the volcanic arena as cosmic rays continue to increase into unprecedented territory as we have entered the new cosmic ray maximum. Events like this are going to be commonplace. The media can only ignore it for so long. We're not ignoring it. We're covering it. Western heat and monsoon continues, increasing moisture in the east. High pressure continues to produce excessive heat in just a few states in the continental U.S., including the west. Critical fire weather conditions for portions of that area, including Oregon, Washington, and Northern Cali. Most of Northern Nevada also in that region, with heavy rains and potential for flash flooding associated with the monsoons in the southwest. Meanwhile, a cold front approaching the east coast is increasing the humidity and heat index and bringing potential for heavy rain and flash flooding. Guys, east of the Continental Divide for the rest of July, up to 3 degrees below normal. And in the Nebraska and the Grain Belt here, it's going to be up to 10 degrees below normal. So just preparing you for what's happening in the next 2 weeks across the entire U.S., below normal temperatures. This information coming from 40-year veteran meteorologist Joe Bastardi at Weather Bells. Now, Saturday summary that he does, he shows how the Earth's surface has cooled dramatically over the past 3 years, especially the sea surface temperatures. And the Arctic sea ice is, in fact, piling up at multi-decadal highs based on data. He also talks about a hurricane threat to the East Coast due to natural factors, including the hottest sea surface temperatures off the coast of New England, which could lead to a Category 3 storm wreaking havoc on New England this year. My forecast as well, I agree with Joe's forecast, based on sea surface temperatures and historic data. Back in 1938, the Northeast was hit with a catastrophic hurricane. Back in the Dalton Minimum back in 1815, also hit with a catastrophic hurricane. Having to do with cosmic rays. Now, his Saturday summary, awesome. And you can see here the 2015 temps. Look how red it is. Global warming. And then the 2018 temps. Look at the difference. Now, the area concerned, the warmest waters are right up here. So we would imagine any hurricane coming into this region would intensify in the last 100 miles before it hit the coast. Anything hugging the shore would intensify greatly up in the Nova Scotia region. So we're looking for a massive Nova Scotia hurricane or New England hurricane by the end of the season. That's a heads up. There could also be some Gulf activity here. Look at the warm area. But look at the difference between the sea surface and the Pacific to today. Immense cooling in just a few years. Come over and check out his Saturday summary where you can see what I just showed you. Definitely cooler. Look at all the red there. Look at all the red there. Definitely cooler. Okay, so come check out the Saturday summary. He's picking up what we're putting down. He even ends the video on this picture of Greenland and how the entire Arctic waters up here and the waters off of Labrador are completely below normal. Hasn't been like this for years. This is what we would expect when glaciation begins up in Baffin Island. And you can see here a region right here actually up to 6 degrees C below normal up in the Hudson Bay region. Thanks, Joe Bastardi, for espousing the truth. Now, Governor Walker declared a state of emergency for Washington Island. Heads up. Governor Scott Walker has declared a state of emergency for Door County Island. The declaration was in response to Washington Island's power loss in June caused by severely ice-damaged underwater electric cable. Now, you only get severely ice-damaged underwater electric cable when there is unprecedented cooling on Earth, because that cable's been there for decades and it has never been damaged. So here we have more effects of infrastructure that is going to begin to crumble quickly. As the planet cools and crops fail and global unrest ensues, record cold in Australia coming from the Herald Sun. But when it's record cold, the news reports don't mention global warming. How cold is it? 006 degrees was the coldest night in 78 years. That's almost 8 decades before any of you people commenting below saying, isn't it winter in the Southern Hemisphere? Yeah, it's the coldest in winter in 78 years. Lithgow, negative 9.3, was the coldest since 72. 5 decades. As I've said repeatedly, we have far more to worry about should the planet cool. Did you hear about the red knots and ruddy turnstones failing to breed this year along the Arctic's islands because of record snow cover? Boom! Your head must be overflowing with knowledge. Coldest morning in 6 decades for parts of the east coast of Australia. After the bomb said it was going to be the warmest winter ever. It is in fact the coldest winter ever. Or one of the coldest. In fact, the coldest morning in 60 years for parts of the east coast. The cold snap has delivered some of the chilliest temperature in decades to parts of Australia's east coast, with more frosty mornings to come. Regardless of what the bomb lied to you about. Both Parkes and Cowra in New South Wales have set new all-time cold minimum temperatures. Records today with the mercury dropping to negative 6.6, negative 5.8 degrees respectively. Both sites opened back in 1958. Dubbo's low of 6 was the coldest in 78 years, while Lithgow's 9.3 coldest since 1972. In Sydney, temperatures remained above zero, dropping to 5.1, while Melbourne was too far behind, dropping to 6.7. And here we see a chemtrail cutting through the sun. Clearly, the powers that be in HAARP and chemtrails and global warming. And Tyler, there could be an alien in there. Really, a ship. Did you see it? Could be that. Nibiru in this region. Heads up. Brisbane woke to its coldest morning in 4 years with temperatures in the CBD. We love that, especially when it's whole plant extract from hemp lucid. Get 20% off down below. But by far the chilliest major city on the map was Canberra, with the capital waking to a chilly negative 4.8. I'll tell you what, put your knickers on. Icy conditions are thanks to the grand solar minimum. Solar decline. Oh, and the predictions do not look good. If you look at solar cycle 24, it is smaller than any cycle since 1875. And solar cycle 25 is embarrassingly low. Yes. If you're not stockpiling food like grandma and you're watching Netflix, please unsubscribe to the channel. Tamworth records the coldest morning ever. With negative 8.6. Clearly there's water frozen there in that little jug. The region and state have shivered through the coldest weekends on record ever, with temperatures dipping below negative 8 degrees in Tamworth on both Saturday and Sunday with a capital U. Can you imagine? According to WeatherZone, a capital U in Sunday. The Highlands area around Tamworth even recorded double-digit negative figures. Are you picking up what we're putting down? Residents reporting negative 1E1 in Bendemeer. Yes, that's negative 11. 11-teen to some of you people. As images emerge of the mighty McDonald River frozen over, which hasn't been seen since the likes of the Maunder Minimum, but records have only been kept for 5 decades, so they don't give in that area anyway. They just make shit up as they go. Now, Armingdale dipped to negative 10.1 on Sunday, with the New England police called out to at least one accident involving black ice, which they've never heard before, and they actually thought was a Negro in the road. Can you believe it? Atrocious. Absolutely. Black ice matters. More snow in Matruesberg. It's true, it snows in Africa. There's pictures. Yes, and it is winter. Violent Nicaragua protests claim 10 lives. And the global unrest unfolds before your very lives. Apparently she's worried about germs while she risks her life to protest the government. Magnitude 4.0 in Christchurch, downgraded by the U.S. Geological Society, which could be called the U.S. Geological Downgrade Service. Totally full of shite. But we'll come here anyway, and I'll show you the downgraded spot right here. It's true, 3.7 downgraded from 4.0 from official sources in that region. Now, major quake of note, 6.0 in Yemen. Definitely set off by the government so that we could kill some of those rugheads. But probably not, just having to do with KP being very low and the earth moving in that region. So please take your tinfoil hat off. We had a 5.0 in Japan at 62 kilometers, followed by a 4.7 at 28 kilometers. And we have a quake in the depth zone, 5.2, out here in Segave, Wallace, and Fortuna at 410 kilometers. So look for a larger quake up in the Tonga region at any moment. We also have continuous explosions at Kilauea, 5.2. And fissure rate continues to erupt in epic fashion with no change, except more lays, more SO4, and more land that will be sold on the cheap. Now, do you know about geophone program? Well, no, you do now. Comes out of Potsdam. That's in Germany. Helps Hodgkin Zentrum. Automatic Geophone Global Seismic Monitor. Deutsches Geoforschungszentrum. Du hast ein kleines Schniedelwurzel? Nein. Now, the most recent large event, Eastern Gulf of Aden, 6.0, at 10 kilometers, confirmed, and it's been blinking all day. Here's other little circles of note that you can go check out. See what they got going down here. You can't even click on it. This site blows. Officially. But if you don't know about it, now you do. Man, I like having fun. Worldwide volcano news update. Sabankaya, volcanic ash. We have Dukono, volcanic ash observed. As well as Fuego, Karaminsk, Krakatau, Dukono, Agung, Sabankaya, Cotopaxi. Holy craxy! Cotopaxi, typically a large, violently exploding volcano, back in the news. Heads up. Yes, it's true. More volcanoes added to the list every day. Eruption at Mount Agung ejects ash up to 5.2 kilometers. That's 17,000 feet to you people in the U.S. ASL, Bali, Indonesia. Whew. Moderately strong eruption took place at Mount Agung, Bali, Indonesia for the 27th time in the last year. July 15th, 2018, ash column rose 17,000 feet above sea level, according to Darwin Bach. The eruption lasted 1 minute and 45 seconds, which means it will only take you 1 minute and 45 seconds to watch it over here at Volcano YT, because they have it live. They record it that way so that you can watch the destruction of the planet in real time. So we'll know it the moment it will be dark the next morning. That's how it's going to work, kids. So if you're prepared, there's no reason to your pants on that morning. You'll simply take solace in the knowledge that you have at least a year of dry goods stockpiled. You haven't told anyone. You have a million rounds of ammunition, and now you're packing heat because you're not letting anyone in. It's true. Wait a minute. Yes, Agung erupted. According to Sutpo, Agung's status remains level 3. Sayaga. Yes. So, let's look at the long-term outlook from April through May. Oh, we just lost it. Let's go back. Apparently all the Twitter. Whew. Okay, look at it. So what we see is a sloping up in the yellows. I don't know if that means anything significant, but there's definitely an uptick in this yellow stuff since June 25th. Watching the uptick in the yellow stuff very closely. Again, come over to Volcano YT to look at the amazing footage of this volcanic eruption, which happened on the 15th of July. Just 2 days after. Why isn't this in? What's going on? We've frozen up. Look at the cars going down there. Oh, someone was adjusting the camera. Imagine if you were a skydiver and you just went right through there. That'd be amazing. Probably would be very hot. Guys, if you don't know about magma.vsi.esdm.go.id, then you're just like me. But no, for real, it is the Magma Indonesia site. And if you walk in, they link you to it and they talk about it. It is amazing map of the Indonesia region. Down here, we can see where Krakatoa is here near Jakarta. You just click on the volcano you want to know about right here. Boom. And it usually works. Apparently, we don't have the bandwidth. But you can see this is where Krakatoa is over here, this little flaming beast here. Guess what that is? That's a gong. We just looked at it. We have two other flamers over here, and we have a 5.0 kicking off. Yes, we are definitely overloading the system here. Heads up. And as you can see, it clearly is only monitoring the Indonesia region because it is Magma Indonesia. So this is an interactive map where you can come look at the seismicity and the volcanoes when you don't have 47 tabs open and you're making a video. And typically when you click on the volcano, like I just did, it will give you the information. Just scroll down and it's real time, so sometimes it's scrolling by you. So you can see a recent picture here and it tells you it's Anak Krakatau, which I just told you that's Krakatoa. And over here we have a gong. There was just a 4.0 magnitude coming off of a gong. So it's real-time data about the volcano. Pretty amazing sight. Nothing like the US has. It's crazy how Magma Indonesia is well ahead of the US and many other countries. Might have something to do with the histogram here of Krakatau. Now, we just looked at another histogram of a gong, and you can clearly see here the massive uptick just since mid-June. This is only 1 month where the other one was many months. So this has rapidly increased and has been erupting since mid-June. So we're going to watch this. Look at the ramp up here. If it goes up to the sky here where this peaked, look out. We're going to be watching this closely. Could be a rapid cooling of Earth and it could make everyone run around and buy everything out of the stores and start to eat their neighbors. Elusive trigger for cooling 13,000 years ago. Might have been found. Well, that's not very convincing. Might it have been? Scientists may have solved a huge riddle in Earth's climate past. It doesn't bode well for the future. If you watch my friend Christian Westbrook's video today, aka Ice Age Farmer, the title of his video is It Doesn't Bode Well. And if you're picking up what he's putting down, the narrative is changing. The mainstream is dabbling in global cooling. Of course, global warming is responsible for global cooling. So it's still all your fault. And here we see the polar bear fatter than hell. This one's not starving. Anyway, so they're blaming the global cooling in the Younger Dryas from global warming. The only thing they don't point out is that was no industry. So massive glacial flood led to ancient 200-year cold snap on Earth, study says. This is coming from the Weather Channel. Doesn't get any more mainstream than this. Remember John Coleman? Yeah, we love him. Rest in peace, John. He was a denier, just like you and I. And that means you're a scientist. It means you're not part of the home team. You're not in the cool club. You know, because the cool club doesn't even know what science is. Now, researchers at Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute are claiming that they just came up with this idea. But I am a scientist from back in the 90s, paleoclimatologist. And I was well aware of the shutdown of the AMOC back in the 90s. Because I'm a glacial scientist, I'm a glacial geologist, I'm a paleoclimatologist. We know about ocean circulation models and how they control glaciation. This has been known for 4 decades. This GISP 2 started coming out of the ground in the 80s, kids. None of this info is new. They're lying to you. This is not a new idea. This is just simply replacing one dogma with another, where they can continue to lie to you and blame you for all the problems on the earth that the globalists are making happen. Now, Japanese scientists are not taking shit from anyone. IPCC models are sloppy and lopsided, says they. Major factors are not adequately represented. And here they prove that just solar wind alone has 100 times more effect than CO2, and they don't include it. So, I love real scientists. Look at this guy. He even has a sensible tie, probably silk. Now, this paper, authored by a team of researchers led by Japanese physical chemist Dr. Kiminori Ito, photo right, examine the influence of changes in solar activity. Can you imagine that? He must be picking up what we're putting down. As predicted, solar activity is rapidly declining, as well as your fate. And the time you have to prepare is also rapidly declining. Let's look at the histogram. Here's the GISP 2 ice core temperature, the current interglacial. Here's the main hockey stick, and here's my red line I just put in moments ago. This is called Diamond's Prediction, and why you should be preparing instead. Well, you should be doing both. Here is the linear progression since 2,000 years ago. Cooler, 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 cooler. The Maya was crushed, the Pueblo Indian, the red paint people ended at a grand solar minimum. The Romans, done. Now here's the whole cooling event 8,200 years ago we talked about yesterday, and we're going well below that in the next 15 years. Yeah, you should be shitting your pants. This guy is keeping us cool, but he's telling us the truth. The solar wind and climate, evaluating the influence of solar wind and temperature and teleconnection patterns using correlation maps. Kimura Oto, Shinya Matsuo, Hishoshi, Shirizawa, Kayushi, Shamashira, and Takashi Amanemiya. That was a lot of words. Guys, here's the whole paper. I'll leave you the PDF. You read it if you care. If you went out earlier, it was not aliens, Tyler. It was Venus and the moon. And I went out earlier and it was cloudy, so I didn't see it. But the Venus and the moon was what you looked at. Those two plasma spheres, the brightest thing in our sky, except for the sun, they were touching. And it was glorious. Look at this picture. And that is going to be the cover of the video. Because as we descend into the grand solar minimum, we're going back to basics. The reason we made stone circles for the last 10,000 years was to warn us of what is about to happen. Knowledge of celestial mechanics was key to farming and to survival. We've lost it. We've replaced it with crony capitalism and a technocracy of nonsense. Up is down and down is up. And I can assure you, the moon will always rise in the same place every 26 years. And Venus will match it. And if you got your panties in the bunch about all the planets being on one side, and then volcanoes erupt every day, every week, new ones. I just showed you another one. Re-erupting. It has nothing to do with all the planets on one side. Now, if the Birkeland currents all align, then maybe something will happen as far as an earthquake. But that planetary alignment is not new. It's not unique. And it's not catastrophic. What is catastrophic is your future. The future we're going into is catastrophic. It has never not been. And if you don't get that yet, then please watch the other 601 videos that I spent my time making to warn the public about. Don't ask down below because you're lazy. Go do your own homework. History repeats itself. We do not learn from the past, and it's time you do. If you don't want your neighbor eating you, then you better be prepared to eat your neighbor. Or better yet, how about you move away from those psychopaths and start learning how to be sustainable? Survive and thrive in the future, growing your own food. All the food is contaminated in the stores anyway. It's all GMO processed, genetically modified, covered in chemicals. It's poison. The number one place you get sick these days is at the doctor. Stop cleaning yourself and go eat some dirt, you idiots. And start prepping now. Maybe even consider the action track chair. I know I did. We all have handicapped friends that want to come with us in the times after. Now, here you're looking at the Central Greenland ice cores. This is high-resolution data. This is my graphic. After the global warming alarmist fudged the data here with the main hockey stick and put it up above the medieval warm, I readjusted it after the papers in the scientific literature told me to. And you could see the clear linear progression down. I'm not the only one that is doing that. Every legitimate scientist is not faking data. You can clearly see here in this GISP2 Greenland ice core data set, the entrails, hail suppression, and all that other nonsense you think that they're doing. They do not control the climate. The sun does. And if you don't know how much bigger than the earth is, then start at the beginning. You have a long way to go. Start prepping now. There is not much time. The next 2 years could be the end. You don't get the things. My computer is shutting down. So I hope you're picking up what we're putting down. We love everyone. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't and get the action track chair or whatever it's called. But get a gun and learn how to shoot it. You might need to. Buy some seeds. We love you. Peace. Be safe.